The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Friends, we are going to talk about omega-3 fatty acids today. What are omega-3? Why people actually are talking about fish oils and people are taking fish oils everywhere. Why omega-3 are important? What do they do? See, fish oils are a dietary source of omega-3s and these are substances, these are fatty acids which are needed by your body, your muscles, your cells for growth, activity, because they are the main anti-inflammatory, they have a main anti-inflammatory action on your body, omega-3. And omega-3 is derived from food. You cannot make it inside your body. It basically contains two types of omega-3. One is a DHA, docohexanoic acid, and the other one is an EPA, eicosapentaenoic acid. So EPA and DHA both are present in fatty fishes, more in fatty fishes like salmon, mackerel, trout, shellfish, then some oysters, crabs, mussels. They also contain these kind of EPA and DHA omega-3s. Vegetarian sources contain a different kind of omega-3 fatty acid, ALA, that is alpha-linolenic acid, which is present in the nuts, seeds, vegetable oils, and etc. etc. This ALA is converted to EPA and DHA in a minor amount, not entirely, and EPA and DHA are the main anti-inflammatory beneficial effect in your body. So that's why taking fish supplement, fish oils or omega-3 supplements are better, right? Omega-3 supplements come in the form of liquid capsules or pill as well, and people who take fish or fish oils have been seen to reduce their heart attack risk, their stroke risk, their triglyceride levels come down, their blood pressure comes down, and they improve their inflammatory conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, right? And even some aging benefits are there. So evidence also suggests that people who have heart disease and they have, if they take like salmon or tuna twice a week, or they take some kind of fish supplement, fish oil supplement, omega-3 supplement perhaps, then it has been seen that it reduces their heart related events like heart attack, or even if there is a heart attack, the heart attack becomes much minor as compared to the people who are not taking fish oil. So fish oils are a good thing to be incorporated in your diet, especially omega-3s, right? EPA and DHA. So even blood pressure control has been seen better with these high triglycerides, and cholesterol controls are better. Arthritis and inflammatory conditions, there is less stiffness, less pain, joint tenderness becomes less, right? So this is a good advantage, and these are generally safe. Omega-3s are very safe. Essentially, they are good for your health. Obviously, if you are taking them from fish, you can broil or bake the fish. Don't fry the fish. And obviously, safer ways to take a fish oil or an omega-3 supplement. Right, omega-3 supplements can be used by almost everyone. And the only side effect is of eating fish. It is that nowadays, because of the contamination of oceans, there can be presence of mercury on the fish's skin. So obviously don't eat the skin, and don't eat those type of fishes, those who eat other fishes, right? Because a fish that eats other fish might have mercury in their system. So don't eat them. That's the only thing which you need to take into consideration, or else you can just take fish oil supplements. Those are also good. And obviously, as far as side effect, everything has side effects. So if you have a reaction or you are having sensitivity to omega-3s or fish oils, you might have a little bit of indigestion, nausea, vomiting, sometimes loose stools can happen, or sometimes just bad breath can happen, or else mostly there is no symptom at all, right? But yes, you have to avoid taking a very large dose, right, of this, or else you might have bleeding inside also, because obviously these have some blood thinning effect in them, just like natural ingredients like clove and ginger garlic, right? Then yes, interactions will also be there. If you are taking some anti-platelets, anticoagulants, herbs, supplements or medicines, whatever, then these omega-3s will increase the effect of those medicines. Same thing will happen with blood pressure medicines or these kind of medicines or herbs or supplements for blood pressure. Your blood pressure will be little more effectively reduced and it might go low, so you have to check that. Contraceptive pills can interfere with the absorption of fish oils, and some medicines like Orlistat, which is given for weight loss, can also reduce the absorption of fish oils or omega-3. And omega-3 can reduce vitamin E levels. Remember all these points. And if we talk about how much omega-3 should you need, so if we talk about fish, if you can consume fish, it is recommended by the American Heart Association that you can take 2 servings of fish every week, 100 grams per serving. So 200 or 250 grams of fish per week is enough to give you ample amount of omega-3s. And in spite of that, instead of that, you can take fish oils or omega-3 supplements. Omega-3 supplements are also effective. You can take 1 capsule a day or 2 capsules a day. That is up to you, depending upon your dosages, right? And obviously your dosages are again determined by your doctor, how much dose is needed. Technically, there is no exact fixed dose for anybody, so you have to consult a doctor, or you can take the dose written on the capsule which you are taking. So if you talk about which kind of capsule should you take, there are so many options in the market, and you can look for EPA and DHA written on the content. That is most important. So if you are looking for suggestion, I would like to suggest N Veda's omega-3 supplement. It has both the EPA and DHA present and also omega-3 fatty acid in good amount, and you can take these supplement once or twice a day, right? This supplement, and avail all the benefits for hypertension, blood pressure, heart problems, stroke, cholesterol, and even joint pain, arthritis, even aging. So this is a very good supplement, should be incorporated in everybody's routine. Even if you're not taking omega-3 supplement, make sure to incorporate fish. If you don't eat fish, then take the supplement. If you're a vegetarian, try to include flax seeds and other things, seeds like walnuts and other dry fruits can also be included. All the seeds have this kind of ALA, but ALA is converted to EPA and DHA in a very little amount, so seeds need to be taken in a higher quantity. Remember that. So this is all about omega-3. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon. I will be giving the links of the omega-3 supplement below. Go and click on it, buy it from there, try it, and let me know how useful they were. Remember, these supplements have to be taken for a long time, maybe 6 months to 1 year, and these are good for your health. So good luck. Make sure to like the video so that it's recommended to others, and I'll see you next time. Stay connected, stay healthy.